Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new. If you are new here, my name is Melissa. Thank you so much for stopping by. Just a little rundown. I do a lot of cleaning motivational videos and lifestyle videos, and now I will be doing pregnancy videos because I am currently pregnant. If you have not seen my last video of me finding out my reaction and telling my husband, then I'll go ahead and leave it in the description box for you below. But if you have seen that video and if you sent us well wishes and congratulated us and just sent positive messages, I just want to say thank you so much. We really appreciate it, and I'm so grateful to be sharing this journey with you guys. So if you are new here and you would like to see more or follow along this journey, I would love to have you subscribe and come along with us. We are so excited. So just a quick rundown, because I do know I have quite a bit of new subscribers here. My husband and I have been trying to conceive for about 3 years before we got our positive. We got our positive on April 7th. During our trying to conceive journey, I did go to doctors and did some testing just to see if everything was normal with my body, and I was able to have kids, and everything came back normal. And same thing for Alex, which is my husband. Things came back normal for him as well. There weren't really any main issues to why we weren't conceiving. I think the only huge problem was that my cycles were very irregular, so it just made it very hard to know when I was ovulating. And I would do ovulation tests and follow the apps, and I just really never trusted the apps, because even though like it would say I'm ovulating, the ovulation test would say otherwise. So things were a bit difficult, but there were times where we just stopped trying, because of course a lot of people say, you know, when you stop trying, it will happen. And let me tell you guys, as much as I really disliked hearing that, and if you are trying to conceive and been trying to conceive for a while, it's probably frustrating to you as well to just hear that, oh, just stop trying and it will happen when it's meant to happen, or it'll happen when you least expect it. But you guys, I promise you, that's pretty much what happened. If you've seen in my last video, or if you haven't watched it yet, you will see that my reaction is completely shocked. I was completely shocked, because I was expecting it to say not pregnant, just because one, we were not trying. Month of March was a little bit rough in the trying to conceive department, if you know what I mean. So I was really expecting it not to say pregnant at all. So completely shocked. But like I said, we are extremely happy. Not yet following me on Instagram, go ahead and do so. I'll leave that in the description box below for you guys as well. But I did post my friends and family reaction video on there, so you guys can see how they reacted. And that video just means so much to me, because it's so special. They waited just as long as we did, so they are just as excited. Okay, so let's talk about baby and how I've been feeling since I found out I was pregnant. So I have my phone here because I have notes that I've been taking. But I had my first doctor's appointment April 23rd, which put me at 7 weeks based off my last period. But when she did the ultrasound, I was actually measuring about a week behind. I was measuring 5 weeks and 5 days, but the baby was healthy and we got to see the heartbeat, and the heart rate was 121, which I was so happy about, because the weeks prior to going to the doctors, I was just so nervous that, like, of course anything could happen. I didn't want to think like that, but that's just how my mindset was going, because I still kept saying, no, this is too good to be true, it's too good to be true. So unfortunately, Alex was unable to go to the first appointment, because when I made the appointment, the receptionist said because of the COVID and all that going on, they're only allowing one person, so only I could go, which I was okay with. I was expecting that anyways. But when I got there, I was a little bit frustrated because my doctor asked, where's dad? And I was like, oh, I was told he couldn't come because of everything going on and just me. And she was like, oh yeah, like, basically she said, like, she was one of the physicians that didn't really mind if the spouse was there as long as it was just the spouse. So I do have another appointment coming up next week, which I'll be almost 10 weeks by then, but he is going to come to that one, and I'm super excited for that because then he can see the baby and hear the heartbeat and do everything with me. I'll insert a clip of the ultrasound at the end of the video, but for now, here is a picture of baby. Don't know if you guys can really see that, but it's really tiny. I call him our tiny, or her, him or her. I call it a boy also. Obviously, we don't know. Okay, so now let's talk about symptoms. since finding out. So I'll say my symptoms from week 4 to 6 were pretty much the same. I was crampy, like just mild cramps, which my doctor said was normal. I was really tired, like I had to nap at least once a day, and it would be like in the evening, like around 6. I was hungry constantly. My boobs were really sore, but I did not have sickness. And people would ask me, oh, are you feeling sick? And I'm like, no, I'm not feeling sick. Like, I was feeling fine. You guys, I thought I was in the clear. And let me just tell you, no. I thought wrong, completely wrong. At week 7, it hit me. And it hit me at night, like right before bed. And ever since then, it's been a daily thing. It's on and off. Some days are better than others. And it's not just in the morning. It's throughout the whole day. It just comes and goes whenever it wants. Some days, I just don't want to do anything. Days like today, I'm actually feeling pretty good. This morning was a little bit rough, but I'm feeling good. At least good enough to film a video for you guys, because I wanted to do this a long time ago, but I just didn't have the energy to do so. But a couple things that I'm using to try and help with my sickness. I bought these Morning Ease lemon ginger drops. I don't have a problem with ginger. I know like gingins, like, which I think are like just ginger drops, are good also. But I want to try the lemon ginger ones. And then Alex recently got me these Preggy Pop Drops Plus, the sour raspberry and sour lemon flavor. Which honestly, I almost prefer these over the Morning Ease. And then I'm also like drinking ginger ale and eating smaller portions throughout the day. So I'm not eating like bigger portions, because I read that that helps. But if you guys have like any suggestions on sickness throughout the day and what helps, go ahead and leave it down below for me. Because I'm willing to try anything. Some people say that it goes away after your first trimester. Some people say they had it their entire pregnancy, or that it came back. But I'm really hoping mine just lasts through the first trimester. But we'll see. Again, I just want to say thank you so much for all the sweet comments you guys sent me, and all the positive feedback and well wishes. And for all my new subscribers, thank you so much for subscribing and following along this journey with us. I'm so excited to be sharing it with you. And for those that have been here since the beginning, thank you so much for sticking around. Again, if you're not following me on Instagram, go ahead and do so. I'll leave it linked down below for you, so that way you don't miss any baby updates. That's where I post the most about the baby and how I'm feeling and just life in general. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video.